Diplomacy is a tricky art, especially when entire nations are on the line in every little decision. Teddy Loxin Jr. shares with us his opinion of our top diplomat in tonight's Teditorial.
Thank you, Sess. The smart man in the cabinet, forthright and forthcoming Foreign Affairs Secretary Del Rosario, made his first mistake. Yet, even when wrong, Del Rosario is right. A Chinese state organization announced countries disputing China's claim to territories in the South China Sea should mentally prepare themselves for the sound of cannons if they will not surrender to China's demands. Del Rosario objected. Territorial disputes should be settled by international rules, not artillery. The Chinese agree, but added, if the rules do not settle disputes to China's satisfaction, some military action is necessary. Exact quote. We think Del Rosario was wrong to call this canonic statement grossly irresponsible. No, it is better than grossly irresponsible. It is revealing. It is hard enough to get totalitarian countries to say anything. What more, reveal their true intentions. Any statement coming out of them should be welcome. Yet, even when wrong, Del Rosario is right. While we welcome the chance to read China's mind, it is a diplomatic imperative to voice our objection to their declared intention to use force if they will not get their way. Otherwise, our silence will be taken as consent, and we cannot consent to force as a mode of conflict resolution. Our only force is the U.S. 7th Fleet, if America allows. Del Rosario stands head and shoulders over his colleagues, which may mean his days are numbered. But while he lasts, we are safe. Meanwhile, the writer, publisher, editors, and staff of that Chinese newspaper probably paid for the bullets and may be on their way to the football stadium to meet their maker, Karl Marx. They violated the cardinal rule of communist China, laid down by Deng Xiaoping, like Washington's last advice to his countrymen to avoid foreign entanglements. In China's case, Deng said in a telegraphic memo, "Do not confront or threaten. Build up national power. Advance by small steps and always hide our intentions. And wait. Wait until the fruit rots on the branch and falls, then pick up." Countries like ours are rotting. Meanwhile, Noi Noi struck a naval information sharing agreement with Vietnam, which is on the Asian mainland, flush against the underbelly of China. Right move, but wrong to announce it. Speak softly, or don't speak, when you do not carry even a small stick. Good day and good luck. Back to you, Sess.
Thank you, Teddy, and enjoy the weekend.